Serotonin, what is it and why is it important? G'day there, I'm Jesse Crowe, the traveling scientist, and in this video, I'm going to tell you all about serotonin and how you can use it to improve your life. See, serotonin is known as the feel-good hormone, even though it's actually not a hormone, it's a neurotransmitter, a chemical messenger within your body that impacts your mood, your hunger, your memory, your sleep, even your sex drive. And if you have the right amount of serotonin, you feel good. But if you don't have enough serotonin, you might feel depressed or anxious. So I'm going to share with you 5 techniques that you can use to boost your serotonin levels, helping you to feel good physically and mentally. The first technique I want to share with you involves your diet. See, serotonin is made from tryptophan, which is an essential amino acid that we get from eating food. By eating more stuff that's packed with tryptophan, you're going to promote the production of serotonin in your brain. Foods rich in tryptophan include milk, eggs, turkey, cheese, salmon. And for all my vegetarian and vegan homies out there, fruits like pineapple, banana, kiwi, as well as plenty of seeds, nuts, oats, and soy products like edamame and tofu. But just eating tryptophan-rich foods isn't enough. You also need to combine those foods with a secret ingredient. Can you guess what it is? If you said gummy bears, you're actually kind of right. It's carbohydrates. And if you want to understand how this all works, listen to the full episode about serotonin on my new podcast, Traveling Science. But long story short, eat foods rich in tryptophan and combine that with some healthy carbohydrates, maybe not gummy bears, and you will naturally increase your serotonin levels. If you don't want to change your diet, the second tool that you can use to increase your serotonin levels is to take a tryptophan supplement. This would allow you to boost your tryptophan levels quickly and easily. It can be a little bit expensive, but for the sake of your mental health, it's probably worth it. The third tool that you can use to increase your serotonin levels is the sun. See, serotonin levels are naturally lower in the winter months because we're getting less sunlight, and that can leave us feeling kind of sad. But an article by Dr. Randy, awesome name by the way, points out that sunlight on the skin and in our eyes actually promotes the production of serotonin in our body, thereby reducing the incidences of mood and anxiety disorders. If you're in summer right now, you're probably hating the sun. And if you're in winter, you're probably thinking, Jesse, there is no sun. Well, even if it's cloudy or cold, you gotta get out there and soak up what you can. And if it's super hot and sunny, put on some sunscreen and get out there. The fourth tool that you can use to naturally increase your serotonin levels is exercise. A review by Basso and Suzuki has pointed out that in both animal and human models, even small amounts of exercise like running on a treadmill or riding a bike are associated with increased levels of serotonin, which are usually associated with increased mood states, especially when compared to control groups that were not exercising. So if you want to increase your serotonin levels, or if you just want to feel happier, make sure you're getting regular exercise. The fifth tool that you can use to boost your serotonin levels is medication. And it's probably the most effective tool that you can use, but it's also the most dangerous. See, because serotonin does a lot of different things in your body, by targeting serotonin with medication, you can also cause a lot of unwanted side effects. So if you do want to use medication to improve your serotonin, you will need to speak to a doctor first. Serotonin-targeted medications include antidepressants like selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors and monoamine oxidase inhibitors. These drugs work to increase the amount of serotonin you have working in your brain, which makes you feel happier, but they can have some serious side effects. And if you want to learn more about these medications, I've made a video all about them. You can check it out just up here. Finally, I need to tell you about serotonin syndrome. This is what it's called when your body gets too much serotonin and it just doesn't know what to do with it all. And this usually only happens when you're on serotonin boosting medication, but it can be deadly, so please be careful. Serotonin's kind of like a vicious seesaw. You don't want to have too little, but you don't want to have too much either. You want to find that good balance. And if you use the natural tools that I shared with you today, you'll be able to find that balance and optimize your serotonin levels, leaving you feeling awesome physically and mentally. Your mood, your sleep, and your memory will all improve, and you can go ahead and start working on optimizing your dopamine levels next using this video just here. Thanks so much for watching, Legends. I'll catch you next Science Sunday. Cheers.